Welcome to Final Score. We've had a fantastic afternoon of football so far. Where have you been? We've been on the red button since 2:30. I'm glad you're with us now, though, watching the afternoon's drama unfold. Garth, Crooks and Mark Bright, brilliant company, as ever. Let's get straight on, though, with the latest from this afternoon's Premier League matches, starting with events at the Emirates. And it was another high-scoring affair involving Blackpool. Arsenal 5, Blackpool 0 is the latest score. Blackburn Rovers have just gone 2-1 up at St Andrews against Birmingham City. Everton 1, Wolverhampton Wanderers 0. Tim Cahill with the goal there. It's Stoke 1, Tottenham Hotspur 2. It's West Bromwich Albion 0, Sunderland 0, West Ham United 0, Bolton Wanderers 2, and Wigan Athletic and Chelsea, of course, is actually Birmingham have actually scored 2-1, not Blackburn Rovers. That goal just happened as we've gone on air. And it's Wigan Chelsea is the tea time kickoff. What have you seen that's impressed you so far, guys?
Well, it's been goals all across the Premiership. It's been a fantastic afternoon for goals. I have to say, first and foremost, how disappointed I've been with the Arsenal-Blackpool tie, because I think the referee spoilt the game. I think he spoilt the game, as my erstwhile colleague would say, because he's kept the letter of the law. I felt he should have been used his discretion.
But would that have made any difference, really, to the comprehensive victory that Arsenal have had this
Perhaps
afternoon?
Perhaps not, but we would have had a contest.
OK. We're going to go now to hear from Damian Johnson. A goal to tell us about at Goodison Park.
Real drama here, Gabby. Wolves have equalised against the run of play. Ebanks Blake eventually put the ball in the net. Controversial because Carl Henry won the ball. It was a 50-50 challenge with Heitinger. Heitinger's still down. Wolves broke away and Ebanks Blake scored from the resultant cross. Before that, it had been all Everton. Tim Cahill gave them the lead. In controversial circumstances, they thought they'd had a penalty. Referee Lee Mason said the foul on Arteta was outside the box. The free kick rebounded to Cahill and he scored. But Ebanks Blake, against the run of play, has got Wolves back into it. 1-1.
Thank you, Damien. A goal at the Cardiff City Stadium. Jason Mohammed can tell us.
And Cardiff City, Gabby, have fired a warning to the Championship. Gone is the hangover of losing out to Blackpool in the playoff final in May. Craig Bellamy involved in the goal. His through ball through to the substitute, Chris Burke. His first touch was beautiful. Took him past the Doncaster back four and fired it past Neil Sullivan. Bellamy's influence growing, Gabby. 69 minutes gone. Cardiff City 3, Doncaster Rovers 0.
OK, so a high-scoring affair, but not the way Blackpool might have liked it. Not their experience of the Premier League thus far, David Garrido. Fill us in with all the details from the Emirates.
OK, so Arsenal 5, Blackpool 0, as you just mentioned, Gabby. Wonder how many papers are going to use the word roller coaster to describe Blackpool's season so far. Of course, 4-0 winners at Wigan last weekend on the end of a pacing and a half today, but this is what the Premier League is all about, boys. Theo Walcott with a hat-trick, all three goals as a result of sweeping, fluid, incisive Arsenal moves. Abu Diaby also getting on the score sheet set up by Thomas Rosicky. Very impressive from him today, and Bakary Sagna. But the real talking point, as Garth mentioned, was that second goal. Ian Evatt bringing down Marouane Chamakh, but it looked outside the box. Nevertheless, referee Mike Jones pointed to the spot and showed Evatt a straight red card. Andre Arshavin converting the penalty. Blackpool have fought gamely throughout, especially in the first half, but we've been chasing shadows in the second, and it could yet get worse. Arsenal 5, 10-man Blackpool 0.
Thank you, David. Roger Johnson is at the Britannia Stadium and watching Stoke against Tottenham. You've seen the good, the bad and the ugly of goals there today.
Yeah, indeed. Three of them, Stoke 1, Tottenham 2. Both the Tottenham goals in a largely scrappy match came from Gareth Bale. One was fortuitous and slightly embarrassing. The ugly, I think you'd refer to it as, Gabby. It ricocheted in off his face from close range. The second, quite simply, an exquisite left foot volley from Lennon's angle ball. Bale's execution and technique were outstanding. Stoke's goal came between Bale's brace, Ricardo Fuller pouncing to poke home a loose ball from an Etherington corner. Half chances to either side around the goals, but Stoke have brought Tunchai on from the bench. He's brought new vim and vigour up front for them, and he almost deceived Gomez with a deflected shot which was dipping in under the crossbar. The intensity is ratcheting up even, as we move into the final quarter hour. Stoke City 1, Tottenham 2.
That's how intense it is. Let's go to Upton Park. Avram Grant's debut as manager of West Ham at home in the league. Not going very well, Mark Bishop.
Going very badly, Gabby. West Ham United 0, Bolton Wanderers 2 is the score at the moment. Avram Grant's honeymoon period well and truly over. More than 32,000 here at Upton Park starting to express their wrath against their new manager. Carlton Cole, dreadful in the first half. A penalty miss, so weak that Jaskalainen almost didn't bother to save it to his right-hand side. Missed a couple of sitters too. Barrera and Piquion on, pressing on their first full league starts for West Ham. Dazzled in the first half, but Cole wasteful. And then Upson with an awful own goal, heading the ball past a Green. Another goal had to come. Lee Chung-Yong's delicious, sweet cross out on the right. Elmander, a powerful header. 2-0 Bolton. Bolton cruising. They're on course to win their seventh successive match against West Ham. West Ham 0, Bolton 2.
We'll get back to the other Premier League updates for you in a moment, but let's go down to the Championship. Alan Biggs is at Turf Moor for us. It's Burnley-Leicester, and there's a penalty incident.
Well, Burnley already have a two-goal lead. It's likely to be three. The ball is put on the spot by Graham Alexander. It's his 900th career start today, the Burnley captain. He's going to crown it with a penalty goal. He comes up now, sends the substitute keeper Conrad Logan of Leicester the wrong way and buries it. This after substitute Chris Eagles was tripped just now by another substitute, Leicester's Lamy. A landmark goal on another big day for Graham Alexander. And quickly to tell you, another landmark today for the earlier scorer in the second half, Chris Iwolumo. His 100th career goal with a header from a great cross from Ross Wallace. And earlier it was Wallace's deflected strike to put Burnley ahead just before half-time. It's emphatic now. Burnley 3, Leicester 0.
And well done, Graham Alexander. 900 games. Incredible stuff. Let's go in to St Andrews, to Steve Lee, and check in there. The goal happened just as we were going off on air, so just tell us all about it, Steve, the goal that gives Birmingham the lead.
Yes, it's Birmingham 2, Blackburn 1. Birmingham coming from behind very well indeed. And Craig Gardner with an absolute beauty, 25-yard as he ran with the ball and then fired it past Paul Robinson. There's been a dramatic first 20 minutes of this second half. We had a missed penalty from Morten Gams Pedersen, and then another corner from Morten Gams Pedersen, who's been excellent all afternoon. Saw Stephen and Zonzi head Blackburn in front, although it's fair to say Foster was being impeded. But Birmingham hit back, and a deep cross into the Blackburn area saw McFadden knock it across for Craig Gardner to equalise. Then we had the Craig Gardner goal 2-1. And just to add to the story, Matt Derbyshire, who used to play for Blackburn, has just come on from Birmingham, his new club. 2-1 to the Blues.
Let's go to the Hawthorns. Ivan Gaskell, a goal at last.
Yes, and a new name to the Premier League has just announced himself officially. Peter Odem Wingie, who was signed by West Brom, by Lokomotiv Moscow this week, their sixth season summer signing, should I say, for this season. And he's just put West Brom in the lead with a very neatly taken goal. Morrison's through ball very nicely found a gap in the Sunderland defence, and Odem Wingie, in his luminous yellow boots, very nicely slipped the ball past Simon Mignolet. It's the first goal of the afternoon. In my view, West Brom have shaded it, but they hadn't up to this point managed to finish it off. Maybe they have now with Odem Wingie. Remember the name.
Thank you very much, Ivan. Beautifully said. Let's go to Upton Park. Mark Bishop, some good news for Hammers fans.
Good news for Hammers fans, Gabby. West Ham United 1, Bolton Wanderers 2, with just over 12 minutes left. You can probably hear over 32,000 come to life here at Upton Park. Mark Noble from the penalty spot. Jaskalainen no chance after Parker was pushed in the back by Paul Robinson, who'd already been yellow carded. Why didn't he get a red from Andrew Mariner, who has had a lot of abuse from the West Ham fans in the first half, especially when it seemed as if a handball had been given by Zach Knight, clearly from a Carlton Cole shot. Nevertheless, West Ham back in this game. 11 minutes left. West Ham 1, Bolton Wanderers 2.
OK, let's go to Loftus Road. QPR start of the day, top of the league. Lunchtime fixtures meant they've slipped down a bit, but it's looking like they could be back on top tonight, Mark Webber. An impressive performance so far.
Indeed. QPR 2, Scunthorpe United 0. You know, Gabby, the last time QPR fans were this interested in mathematical equations, Carol Vorderman was presenting Countdown, because goal difference will be all it takes to propel QPR to the top of the Championship today for the first time since 2005, and the odds are rampant, especially today's captain, Adel Tarabert, who times has left the Scunthorpe defence as motionless as a Kraftwerk tribute band in mid-concert. His hard work inspired the two goals. Bradley Orr to his tap-in, Heider Helgerson to his lob. Scunthorpe have had punctuated attacks flattened by some poor close-range fluff shots. QPR 2, Scunthorpe 0.
Mark, you got there in the end. Thank you very much. Let's go to Selhurst Park now. Lizzie Greenwood-Hughes watching Crystal Palace Ipswich, but I wonder, Lizzie Greenwood-Hughes, what Edgar Davids will think of Crystal Palace's performance this afternoon.
I wonder, and I also wonder what he thinks of the handbags, which have just been persistent throughout this entire game. We've just had a bit more, and we've had more yellow cards. We've had another red card. Now both teams are down to 10 men. But Palace, of course, lost Claude Davis a little bit earlier on in the second half after he clearly pulled back John Stead, which led to the penalty, which gave Ipswich their first goal. Ipswich then struck again soon after with Carlos Edwards flicking into the top right-hand corner of the goal. But if this match was going to be scored on possession, then really Palace should be leading 2-0. But at the moment, with about 10 minutes to go, they're losing 2-0 to Ipswich Town.
Lizzie, thank you very much. Let's go back to the Emirates. Another goal for David Garrido to tell us about.
Guess who it's gone to? Three guesses. I don't think you actually need even one. Arsenal 6, Blackpool 0. Very simple this time. Sovereign Van Persie with a corner, headed home by Marouane Chamakh despite the best efforts of the very unfortunate this afternoon, Matthew Jilks. A first Gunners goal then for the summer signing from Bordeaux. He's really deserved it. He's linked up so well with his midfielders all afternoon, and a goal really to reward his efforts. It's Arsenal 6 now, 10-man Blackpool 0.
It's going to be a long journey back to the seaside, isn't it? And a very different atmosphere for the Tangerine fans this afternoon.
One week you're on the giving end, the next week you're on the receiving end, but there was a big decision with the penalty and the sending off. I think it was going to be difficult for Blackpool anyway. But you know what? David Greedo's right. Shamrock's played ever so well. Great header. And that's one thing that, you know, he's brought to the Arsenal side. His aerial prowess, you know, and he deserves that goal today.
When you watch Match of the Day tonight, there are two things that characterise the whole of Match of the Day. Referees' decisions. It's the second week of the Premier League season, but there have been some shocking referees' decisions. And also, West Ham are in real trouble this season if they don't do something very quickly with the personnel there.
OK, and what about Birmingham City Blackburn Rovers? Second week that Birmingham City have had a bit of a comeback. At the moment, it's a comeback that's looking like it's going to get them 3 points. Impressed with their performance?
I thought it was Birmingham who made the comeback, wasn't it? 2-1?
Yeah, I said they've made a comeback. Birmingham made a comeback week running.
But the crowd booing.
They did it last week against Sunderland.
Sorry,
this week,
Gabby,
they've done it against Blackburn Rovers.
Just got to concentrate. yeah, the crowd were booing a little bit as well. You're thinking, finished ninth last year, top half of the Premier League table, and they show some real resilience at home, Birmingham.
OK, thank you very much. Let's go to Carrow Road, a penalty incident. Robin Bailey can tell us who's won it.
Well, no one's scored it yet. Swansea are about to take it. It's David Cotterill who's just shaping it up with John Ruddy ahead of him. It was won by Scott Sinclair, and it's saved, a brilliant save by Ruddy in goal for Norwich. Absolutely brilliant. Down low to his right, tipped it onto the post, and it's out. And Swansea really worth a lead in the second half. They have out-footballed Norwich. They've had the best of the chances. Scott Sinclair, who won the penalty, and it was rightly given, by the way, has been excellent. He's had a couple of runs, couple of chances, and now the game's alight. It's still 0-0, though.
OK, we've got some goal news at Upton Park. Mark Bishop, is it an equaliser?
West Ham 1, Bolton Wanderers 3. It's going to be a long, long night for Avram Grant, Gabby. Keystone Kops moment, number 2 this time in the middle of the back four for West Ham United. Both defenders, Dithering and Elmander, who's been on fire throughout this match, helping himself to an easy goal. West Ham thought they had a bit of a comeback when Noble got a goal back from the penalty spot, but Bolton really capitalising on some awful errors in the back four with West Ham. 32,000 fans here at Upton Park, most of them all West Ham fans, and a large contingent are leaving the ground. West Ham 1, Bolton Wanderers 3.
Crew have had a buoyant afternoon. 7 they've put past Barnet. AJ Leach-Smith with the 7th goal on 82 minutes. Let's go up to the SPL, and Brian McLaughlin is up at McDermott Park. St Johnstone Aberdeen, and are Aberdeen looking like they're going to win this one?
Well, they're certainly on course to do so. They've just taken the lead. Substitute Darren Mackey scoring with just 5 minutes left for play. It was Sonny Lucas' run down the left-hand side. His cross into the box. Darren Mackey didn't catch it cleanly, but cleanly enough to send the ball past Peter Enkelman and into the back of the net. With just a few minutes left for play now, 3 minutes. It's St Johnstone 0, Aberdeen 1.
Two teams at the Valley started the day top of the table. Lindsay Hooper, anybody looking like they're going to come out on top tonight?
No, I think this one's got a draw written all over it, Gabby. Charlton 1, Oldham 1. There has been some sprightly action, though, in the last 10 minutes. So you think that they're kind of on that last-ditch effort trying to get the winning goal. It started for Charlton. Scott Wagstaff scored from 10 yards out, fired into the top right-hand corner. And the second goal coming just before the break as well. It was a 20-yard scorcher for Dean Furman for Oldham. And the nearest they've come since was through Tunkara. So Oldham with the best chance, Rob Elliott saving with one hand. But it's Charlton 1. Oldham 1.
Let's go to Hillsborough. Sheffield Wednesday had a pretty good start to the season, Andrew James, haven't they? And you've been fairly impressed this afternoon.
Yes, they have. They lead by a goal to nil, Gabby, from Giles Coke just before half-time. He almost scored a second carbon copy early in the second half, striking the ball sweetly. Ankergren couldn't stop it. Best from Brighton, a Jamie Smith effort that hit the bar. But with just under 20,000 here today, Sheffield Wednesday look confident. They look to have got momentum already, and they'll be very strong in terms of promotion contenders from League One this season. They lead Brighton by a goal to nil.
Let's go to the Cardiff City Stadium. Cardiff City, in association with Craig Bellamy, as we're calling them, against Doncaster Rovers. Jason Mohammed, is he still on the pitch?
He's still on the pitch, but in the past 10 seconds, he's just been given a yellow card for some reason. I presume that it was back chatting to the referee and throwing the ball away. He's done quite a lot of that. But the Craig Bellamy Show, Gabby, has seen 4,000 shirts sold with 39 Bellamy on the back. A sellout crowd here at the Cardiff City Stadium. And Cardiff City's high-profile supporters are out in force as well. The former Labour leader, Lord Kinnock, told me it was like a dream to have the Wales captain at the club. But it's no dream start for Bellamy. When he's had the ball, obviously he has looked a different class. Touch, pace, vision. He is a brilliant footballer. But after Brian Stock and Billy Sharp both went close for Rovers, Bellamy set up Jay Bothroyd, his ball bouncing luckily to the striker who side-footed past Neil Sullivan. He then got his second brilliant cross from Chris Burke on the right-hand side. And then Bellamy, perhaps the moment of the game, Bellamy puts a beautiful ball through for Chris Burke. His touch was sublime. His first touch took him past the Rovers defence and he slammed home a left-footed shot past Neil Sullivan. It's Cardiff City 3, Doncaster Rovers 0. And I have to say, Doncaster Rovers have been good for 20 minutes, but at the moment, they're being totally outplayed by Bellamy and Cardiff City.
Jason, thank you very much. Let's go to Carrow Road. Another goal for Robin Bailey to tell us about.
Yes, and that penalty save has turned the game because Norwich have scored. They didn't score it. It was an own goal from Ashley Williams, who I have to say has been excellent in defence for Swansea, the Welsh international. No wonder he's got 20 caps. He's a terrific player, but he slid in to try and prevent Anthony McNamee's cross from going any further, and he could only put it in his own net. So Norwich are one up here, and they... An own goal from Ashley Williams.
Thank you very much, Robin. Richard Ascombe is at the KC Stadium. Give us an update there, will you, Richard?
Yes, hi, Gabby. No goals here. A match that has seldom sparkled, really, has just about sparked into life in the last few minutes. We've had chances at both ends. Watford have had the best of them. Martin Taylor heading wide with a goal at his mercy. Danny Graham, four goals already this season, denied by Matt Duke in the home goal. Hull have been full of effort without much quality. That's been the story of this game, really. Richard Garcia with a header just wide with their best opportunity.
Let's go back to the Cardiff City Stadium because, guess what? I think they call it the icing on the cake, don't they, Jason Mohammed?
Well, Gabby, this stadium has seen some wonderful moments in a season, but perhaps the moment of this very young stadium so far. 24,000 supporters are on their feet. They're going absolutely crazy. 30 yards out, Craig Bellamy, direct free kick with his right foot past Neil Sullivan. What a goal. Will Roberto Mancini live to regret this decision, I wonder? Cardiff City 4, Doncaster Rovers 0.
Well, there's no doubt that Manchester City fans think Craig Bellamy was great for them last season. No, it's not his form that the reason he's left, is it? There's no differences.
And as everyone said, for the Championships, it's a great signing. A guy who's not past his best, a star. And, you know, we have to say a star. An ideal signing for Dave Jones. I think last year in the final, Jay Brothard went off and it ruined all their chances. But Bellamy's a great signing for them. It's icing on the cake.
Is there any danger or any worry for you that, you know, he has a certain amount of reputation? Yes, he's a great professional, great player, but he has had his moments, hasn't he?
Of course, like everybody else.
That he would disrupt the dressing room at all, though, well, because he's such a star.
That's the risk you take. But you know what? His quality on the pitch is such that Dave Jones, he's coming to his hometown club where he's in his own environment, his family are there. I don't think he's going to be disruptive. I think it just enhances their chance of getting promotion.
What a story
it would
be if
someone wants to win a football match. Oh, wow. And he's a bit disruptive as well. I'll have that.
Always fighting talk from Mr. Crooks today. Let's go to the Britannia Stadium at Roger Johnson. How's this one looking? Is it going to stay this way for the next few minutes, do you think?
Well, it is, but remember the old debate about goal line technology that we had in the summer? Stoke are probably going to reignite it because Tottenham have just cleared one off the line. Hard to say from a seat high at the back of the stand above the halfway line. I have to say, I don't think it did cross the line, but Stoke protesting madly as we move into 6 minutes of added time here. Still Tottenham lead by 2-1. Stoke have brought on all three of their substitutes, including Sidibe, who got injured within 2 minutes and has himself been substituted. Tottenham, with just one striker up front, Peter Crouch, are hanging on here, but the intensity is at fever pitch. 2-1, Tottenham lead Stoke City.
Should be, shouldn't it? Should Max be a goal. Over the line.
It looks like Gomez tries to punch it. It hits the bar. It drops down. It's then stooped and headed across the line. It doesn't look like it crosses. Is it Crouch?
It's a goal.
Crouch is line on line. I don't think the whole ball. The referee.
It appeared to go right into it, the pit of his stomach and over the line.
Without any shadow of doubt.
I don't think the whole of the ball's over.
The referee, you see the referee mouth. Yeah. I didn't see it.
I can't
see it. And the referee can't give what he doesn't see.
Contentious.
That's part of the game.
See, we all have the same view and we disagree.
And we disagree. Referee's decisions tonight, Gabby, honestly, it's unbelievable.
OK, thank you very much for the moment. Let's head up to the SPL. Brian McLaughlin is at McDermott Park and it's full-time.
It's full-time in St Johnstone. Neil Aberdeen won. The large travelling support here, singing the praises of the team tonight. Dan Mackey's goal, just 7 minutes from time separating the sides. A scoreline harsh on Saints, who battled well throughout. But Aberdeen, it's 2 wins out of 2 and they go top of the SPL team. St Johnstone 0, Aberdeen 1.
Let's check in with Ivan Gaskell as this one draws to a close at the Hawthorns. Are West Brom going to take all the points?
There's your answer. Exactly as you come to me, the crowd's cheers will tell you. The referee's whistle brings to an end a game that for a long time was 0-0 and deserved to be. But West Brom eventually, with 10 minutes to go, well, they found an opening through the Sunderland defence that their more purposeful football throughout really deserved. And the man that has lit up this game for large parts of it on his debut, and forgive him for a tired display, we got the opposite. He only signed yesterday. He came from Lokomotiv Moscow in search of Premier League football, and he's going to write his name in some small part in the headlines tomorrow morning. And a name to conjure with too, Peter Odemwingie. Remember that. He was slipped through by Morrison and then he found a finish to match a very, very impressive first performance. West Brom bouncing back after a 6-goal hammering, and that'll do for his manager. 1-0 here.
And the final whistle is about to blow as well around the Premier League at other grounds. But we're going to go now to Damian Johnson at Goodison Park. It's all over there.
It is 1-1, an old school Premier League tear up this one, as Everton should have had sewn up early in front of the watching Fabio Capello. Controversy surrounded both the goals. Everton should have had a penalty when Arteta was upended in the area. Referee Lee Mason ruled it was outside the box. The resultant free kick was blocked, but Tim Cahill turned the rebound into the net. It was the least the home side deserved after their dominance. Then a sucker punch from Wolves substitute Adlen Guedioura won a 50-50 with Heitinger. Home fans screaming for a foul. Wolves broke and Doyle's crossed for Sylvain Ebanks-Blake to tap in the equaliser. Saha and Cahill went close for Everton. Jarvis for Wolves, but it stayed 1-1.
Let's go to the Emirates. To Carrow Road, a goal, Robin Bailey.
Damian Jackson's put Norwich 2-0 up here, and how the game turned with that John Ruddy goalkeeping save. You know, they've got an excellent under-19 keeper in Declan Ruddy here at Norwich, but John Ruddy has made his name now. Great save from David Cotterill for Swansea, who had been unlucky to lose this game. But Simeon Jackson has scored. The final whistle's just gone to add to that own goal from Ashley Williams earlier. And Norwich have won it. They got away with it a little bit. Swansea a bit unlucky, but Norwich are up and running in the Championship. They win 2-0.
Finding their feet, Norwich in the Championship. Have Crystal Palace managed to find something in their match at Selhurst Park? Lizzie Greenwood-Hughes.
They have. They've just pulled one back, but it's in stoppage time, and it's just too little, too late for the 10-man Crystal Palace against a 10-man Ipswich Town. Neil Dans, the scorer, after a bit of a sort of tussle just inside the box, the ball went up and went over the keeper and just managed to get into the goal. Neil Dans, as I say, the scorer for Crystal Palace, but the game's almost over. They're losing 1-2 at home to Ipswich Town.
Thank you, Lizzie. Let's go to Upton Park. The final whistle has gone and the Hammers fans will be desperately disappointed, as will Avram Grant, with their team's two performances so far this season in the Premier League. Mark Bishop can tell us why.
West Ham United 1, Bolton Wanderers 3. More than 32,000 West Ham fans deserve better than this. They come here full of optimism. They left in despair and they were leaving Upton Park in their droves well before the final whistle, after the prolific Johan Almanda helped himself to an easy third goal for Bolton after yet another defensive mix-up in the middle of the West Ham back four. Abraham Grant's first competitive match in charge of West Ham at Upton Park went completely pear-shaped as soon as Carlton Cole's weak penalty was saved by Jesper Linen. True referee Andre Mariner missed an absolute howler by that night. Clear handball in the Bolton penalty area, nothing given. Bolton came flying out of the traps in the second half. Upson inexplicably headed past Robert Green, who dilly-dally'd onto his line. Almanda then headed Lee Chung Young's deep cross out on the right. Bullet header, Green no chance. Mark Noble penalty had given West Ham hope, but really this was dreadful stuff. They finished in a stadium half empty. Bolton's seventh successive victory over West Ham. West Ham 1, Bolton Wanderers 3.
And it's all over at St Andrews as well. A good fight back from Birmingham City. Steve Lee can tell us more.
Yes, Birmingham 2, Blackburn 1 at the end. For the second week running, a Birmingham comeback has seen them take a share of the spoils. A point at Sunderland last weekend, all three here today. It's now 11 months and 16 games since a home defeat at St Andrews. After a drab first half, Blackburn missed a penalty from Morten Gamst Pedersen. A brilliant save that by Ben Foster. Then Pedersen's corner headed home by Stephen Nzonzi. Suspicion that Foster was impeded, though, by some Blackburn forwards. Birmingham hit back, long ball into the box. McFadden squared for Craig Gardner to equalise. And then the winner, a real kraken from Gardner again, from fully 25 yards. Paul Robinson beaten. Blackburn pushed hard for a way back. Foster was immense in the Birmingham goal. 2-1 to Birmingham.
And to Roger, ready to see and debate on Match of the Day this evening, no doubt. And also in the Championship and League One and League Two, let's have a look at the team who at the moment are flying in the Championship. Mark Webber's at Loftus Road. He saw QPR beat Scunthorpe United.
QPR 2, Scunthorpe United 0. A man in a sombrero waving a Moroccan flag, smiling in front of me. QPR top of the table, and another performance which shows intent for the title. Bradley Orr and Haider Helgeson on the score sheet, but the standing ovation for the Moroccan Adel Tarabat when he was subbed in the second half is a sign of the major role he played in this victory. Scunthorpe had their chances, but they fluffed them all at close range. The keeper Joe Murphy was the biggest hero today. QPR 2, Scunthorpe United 0.
What an exciting day for Cardiff City fans. They saw the local boy come home, Craig Bellamy. So did Jason Mohammed. I don't think you're going to have another day as exciting as this for a while. You've loved this, haven't you?
I tell you something, Gabby. I have never seen so many fans with smiles on their faces. And let's not forget, these are supporters who have had a very uncomfortable summer. There's been the transfer embargo. There's been the heartache of missing out on promotion in the playoff final at Wembley. Would they have a club? Well, they have a new superstar. This stadium has seen its most memorable moment. Cardiff City, how they've managed to pull off the signing of one of the game's most colourful, controversial, brilliant players is something of a mystery. But if you're a Bluebird supporter, who cares? He's here. His class shone through throughout. Craig Bellamy got booked. He scored quite a brilliant free kick. You have to see it tonight on the Football League show. 35 yards out, right-footed past Neil Sullivan. He went off with 3 minutes to go with a standing ovation. Jay Bothroyd thought at one stage during this afternoon he would have the headlines for his two goals. And there were two fine goals. But the local lad is home. And Cardiff City have won by 4-0.
Thank you very much. He's had a great afternoon, Jason Mohammed, hasn't he? And you don't have to wait till this evening. You can see those goals a little bit later on this show. You can see Craig Bellamy's first goal for Cardiff City. Let's check in with Lizzie Greenwood-Hughes all over at Selhurst Park. Too little, too late for the home side.
It is. Crystal Palace have lost this game 1-2 to Ipswich Town, the visitors. And then the Palace will no doubt feel unlucky losing this hotly contested but bad-tempered match here at Selhurst Park. Both Ipswich goals came in the second half, the first leading to the sending off of Crystal Palace's Claude Davis, who clearly pulled back John Stone. Grant Ledbetter, the scorer of that penalty. The second goal was shortly afterwards. Carlos Edwards, a nice flick into the top right-hand corner. Then Andros Townsend was sent off to Ipswich. So both teams down to 10 men, but Palace couldn't make hay with that. And Neil Downs did pull one back in stoppage time, but it was too little, too late. Edgar Davids, well, if he's wondering if he's made a terrible mistake, at least he's only on a pay-as-you-play status here at Crystal Palace. Much better start for the season for Ipswich, though. 7 points in 3 games.
Thanks, Lizzie. Let's get the full classified results now with Tim Gudgin.
And first off, the Barclays Premier League. Arsenal 6, Blackpool 0. Birmingham City 2, Blackburn Rovers 1. Everton 1, Wolverhampton Wanderers 1. Stoke City 1, Tottenham Hotspur 2. West Bromwich Albion 1, Sunderland 0. West Ham United 1, Bolton Wanderers 3. Wigan Athletic and Chelsea kick off shortly at 5:15. In the Empire Championship, Bristol City 3, Barnsley 3. Burnley 3, Leicester City 0. Cardiff City 4, Doncaster Rovers 0. Coventry City 2, Derby County 1. Crystal Palace 1, Ipswich Town 2. Hull City 0, Watford 0. Leeds United 3, Millwall 1. Norwich City 2, Swansea City 0. Preston North End 1, Portsmouth 0. Queen's Park Rangers 2, Scunthorpe United 0. And Reading 1, Nottingham Forest 1. In Empire League 1, Carlisle United 4, Milton Keynes Dons 1. Charlton Athletic 1, Oldham Athletic 1. Exeter City 2, Bristol Rovers 2. Notts County 1, Dagenham and Redbridge 0. Peterborough United 4, Huddersfield Town 2. Rochdale 1, Colchester United 2. Sheffield Wednesday 1, Brighton and Hove Albion 0. Southampton 1, Leighton Orient 1. Swindon Town 1, Brentford 1. Tranmere Rovers 0, AFC Bournemouth 3. Walsall 2, Plymouth Argyle 1. And Yeovil Town 0, Hartlepool United 2. In League 2, Accrington Stanley 3, Macclesfield Town 0. Burton Albion 3, Morecambe 2. Bury 1, Northampton Town 1. Chesterfield 4, Hereford United 0. Crewe Alexandra 7, Barnet 0. Gillingham 0, Lincoln City 1. Rotherham United 6, Cheltenham Town 4. Shrewsbury Town 1, Aldershot Town 1. Southend United 1, Port Vale 3. Stevenage 3, Stockport County 1. Torquay United 2, Bradford City 0. And Wickham Wanderers 0, Oxford United 0. In the Blue Square Bet Premier, AFC Wimbledon 3, Tamworth 0. Altrincham 0, Crawley Town 1. Barrow 2, Rushton and Diamonds 0. Bath 2, York City 2. Cambridge United 0, Southport 0. Eastbourne Borough 4, Wrexham 3. Fleetwood Town 0, Luton Town 3. Forest Green Rovers 1, Gateshead 1. Grimsby Town 1, Hayes and Yedding United 2. Kettering Town 0, Darlington 0. Kidderminster Harriers 1, Mansfield Town 3. And Newport County 2, Histon 2. In the Clydesdale Bank Scottish Premier League, Hamilton Academical 0, Hearts 4, and St Johnstone 0, Aberdeen 1. The Arnbrew Scottish Division 1, Dundee 0, Ross County 0. Falkirk 3, Stirling Albion 0. Greenock Morton 2, Partick Thistle 0. Raith Rovers 2, Dunfermline Athletic 0. In Scottish Div 2, Ayr United 1, Dumbarton 0. East Fife 2, Peterhead 1. Forfar Athletic 1, Brecon City 1. Livingston 2, Airdrie United 1. Stenhouse Muir 0, Alloa Athletic 1. And Scottish Div 3, Albion Rovers 2, Queen's Park 1. Annan Athletic 2, Stranraer 2. Clyde 1, Berwick Rangers 4. Elgin City 0, East Stirlingshire 2, and Montrose 3, Arbroath 0. In the Welsh Premier, Ballertown 2, Bangor City 3. That's the latest score. Carmarthen Town 1, Airbus UK Broughton 4, and Prestatyn Town 1, Haverford West County 0. In the Carling Premiership, Coleraine 0, Crusaders 3, Glenavon 3, Donegal Celtic 1, Linfield 1, Lisburn Distillery 0, Newry City 0, Glentoran 0, and Porter Down 1, Ballymena United 3. Yeah.
One late kickoff. It kicked off at 3:45. Barla Town 2, Bangor City 3 in the Principality Building Society Welsh Premier League. Let's get the tables now for you. The Premier League. Well, no one made it 2 wins from 2 today, so Arsenal lead the way on goal difference thanks to their thumping win against Blackpool. Bolton go second after their win at Upton Park, with Birmingham third thanks to victory against Blackburn. Champions Chelsea face Wigan in the late kickoff, and a win would send them top. At the bottom, West Ham dropped to the foot of the table after losing today. Wigan, Newcastle and Stoke are the only sides without a point, the only other sides without a point. Newly promoted West Brom got off the mark thanks to victory against Sunderland. Let's have a look at the Championship. Queen's Park Rangers maintained their 100% start to the season with victory over Scunthorpe. They're 2 points clear at the top now of Cardiff City. They climbed to second after their 4-0 win over Doncaster Rovers. They're ahead of Burnley, Ipswich and Coventry on goal difference. This morning's leaders, Millwall, are 6, having their perfect start to the season ended by Leeds United. At the other end of the table, Paulo Sousa's Leicester are bottom on goal difference. They lost 3-0 at Turf Moor. Sheffield United and Middlesbrough have the chance to climb the table when they meet at the Riverside tomorrow. Let's have a look at League One. Carlisle top the table on goal difference after beating MK Dons 4-1. Alderman Charlton are just behind them after a 1-1 draw at the Valley, while Sheffield Wednesday also have 7 points after beating Brighton. And at the bottom, newly promoted Dagenham remain without a point or a goal. They replaced Notts County at the bottom after losing 1-0 at Meadow Lane. Southampton began the season as favourites for promotion, but the Saints are still winless after a 1-1 draw with Leighton Orient. And League Two, Torquay 2 points clear at the top. Their perfect start continuing with victory over Bradford City. Chesterfield, Rotherham, Port Vale and Shrewsbury all maintain their unbeaten starts. At the bottom, Barnet find themselves at the foot of the Football League following their 7-0 thumping at the hands of Crewe. Macclesfield slip into the bottom two after losing at Accrington Stanley. And let's have a look at the Blue Square Bet Premier. Well, Luton Town and AFC Wimbledon maintained their 100% starts for the season. Luton topped the table on goal difference after their 3-0 win at Fleetwood Town. At the bottom, Rushden and Diamonds have slipped to the foot of the table after losing to this morning's bottom side, Barrow. And a little look at the SPL with only 2 matches this afternoon, 4 games tomorrow. Aberdeen stay top after Darren Mackey's late winner at St Johnstone. They're 2 points clear of Hearts, who beat bottom side Hamilton 4-0. So let's get the headlines from the Premier League today. West Ham 1, Bolton 3. The Hammers' miserable start under Avram Grant continues. A Matthew Upton own goal and 2 from Johan Elmander gave Bolton victory. Birmingham 2, Blackburn 1. Craig Gardner nets twice as the Blues hit back from a goal down at St Andrews. Everton 1, Wolves 1. Sylvain Evans-Blake earns a point for Wolves, meaning Everton remain without a win. And it's West Brom 1, Sunderland 0. A debut goal from Nigerian star Peter Odemwingie gives the Baggies their first win back in the Premier League. And you can catch all of today's goals, incidents and post-match reaction on Match of the Day, 10:30 on BBC One. Gary's joined by Alan Hansen and Mark Lawrenson. Straight after the Match of the Day, you can see the Football League action rounded up by Manish. And then tomorrow, Match of the Day 2 for you on BBC Two. At 10 o'clock, Newcastle United's first home game against Villa and Manchester United at Craven Cottage tomorrow afternoon. So he said he was really looking forward to taking his team to the Emirates, Ian Holloway. It didn't quite work out as he'd hoped, I imagine. He's speaking to David Garrido.
Ian, you called Arsene Wenger a genius before this game. What do you make of the team that you played this afternoon and their performance?
Well, they're fantastic players, aren't they? And the way they try and play and pass and move is an education to watch. Obviously, we thought we were doing okay for a while, and then, you know, the referees deemed that as a sending off. For me, it's a penalty at best. Nowhere near. I thought he played the ball, to be perfectly honest with you. So, you know, absolutely ruined the game as a spectacle then, and, you know, it could have been a lot worse, I feel, you know. But we've got to get used to the movement and each other as well. You know, when I got a main centre-half, comes off, it's just throw a new fella on, it's not very easy, but some of that football they played is absolutely world class.
Well, respect to Ian Holloway, Jonathan Pearce. You know, he recognises they've played against a great side today, but he seems a little bit sore about the referee's take on that situation.
Well, he thought that Ian Everett had played the ball challenging Chamakh, and for the first two or three replays, I agreed with him. But then we saw another replay that showed quite clearly that Everett didn't touch the ball. Chamakh did, and that the defender therefore fouled the player. I thought it was outside the penalty. It raises the question, if the referee gives a penalty, should he then send the player off? Isn't it sufficient punishment? But under the rules as they stand, he had to. It was a correct decision, and that put the game beyond Blackpool's reach. Later on in that interview, you may see it tonight in Match of the Day, he goes on to say that Walcott was unplayable today. He scored a magnificent hat-trick. Some of Arsenal's movement was beguiling. Their pace, their precision, it was lovely to watch. Diaby scored a good goal. Chamakh completed it, apart from the Arshavin penalty as well. It made it six. It was a convincing Arsenal victory. They were joyous at time in their football. Blackpool, very early on, passable, neatly going forward. No real punch to them, apart from one chance that Taylor Fletcher headed wide. It would have made it 1-1. But Ian Holloway knows, and everyone in the ground knows, that had that been 1-1, Arsenal would have gone on to win 6-1. But they were so much the better team. Real lessons to be learnt for Blackpool today.
Yeah, the difference between this week and last, not just the opposition. Obviously, Wigan last week didn't put up any fight, did they, against them, and their defence was pretty poor. But Blackpool, they're going to want to avoid going out and getting thumped for six every week, aren't they?
Well, it's how they pick themselves up from this. That's what other managers new to the Premier League have said about their teams, how they respond to a heavy defeat. Blackpool need to get themselves going again next week very, very quickly and to come back from, a humbling defeat such as this. Everett will be suspended for the one game. He'll miss the Carling Cup tie. And they can ill afford to miss anyone. They need to strengthen. I gather talks are still going on with Pittman, the Bournemouth striker. Ian Holloway knows he needs five or six players to come in. The last time these two teams met in the league, Gabby, Arsenal were on the way to completing the double and Blackpool were on the way to relegation, and it looked as on the evidence of this 90 minutes. I know we're ridiculously early in the season to say this. We could have the same situation again. You know, when Arsenal revealed the original Herbert Chapman clock back here in September 1930, they won 4-1 against Leicester. They went top of the league. And they revealed a new clock in the ground today, and momentarily, at least, they're top of the league again. They were lovely to watch at times, and sometimes it was a nightmare show for Blackpool, I'm afraid.
Thank you very much, Jonathan. Let's hear now from the Spurs manager, Harry Redknapp. He saw his side win 2-1 at the Britannia Stadium. It was a match not without incident, though, I have to say. Guy Mowbray is talking to him.
Well, Harry, for the second season running, 3 points at Stoke, but a frantic ending for your team.
Yeah, it was always going to. I mean, first half, we had real complete control of the game, didn't we? We passed it fantastic, really. And I knew that Tony would get after them at half-time and they'd try to get in our faces and put us under some pressure. And they did that second half and it became more difficult for us to pass the ball as we did first half. But in the end, we did what we had to do and headed balls away when we had to and got bodies in away when we had to. And, I thought it was a well-deserved win.
Before we clear up the rest of the game, what about that finish? Stoke will feel they got an equaliser. I think you feel justice was done.
Well, if you watch it on the replays, Hoof has pushed Gomez. He's pushed him, so it's a foul. I mean, the referee obviously hasn't seen the foul, so justice was done because it was a foul.
How about the two goals from Gareth Bale? You couldn't get any more different ones, could you?
No, I mean, the second goal was just... That was technique at its best, wasn't it? People talk about volleying a ball, dropping your shoulder, getting your foot up. Around you, you know, fantastic technique. And a young lad watching that, that's how you volley a ball. You don't stay, you fall away, and he got his leg up there and top corner. I mean, that was one of the... There won't be too many better goals than that this season.
And he's got his rewards after a bit of stick last week for missing the chance that could have won the game against City.
Well, he's been great, you know. There wouldn't be a better left-sided player in the country than Gareth, really. You know, he plays left-back, he plays wide left. He's just a fantastic young talent.
Well, he finished the season, didn't he, last season, very strongly, Gareth Bale. And today, he's just given us one of the most beautiful goals you like to see before Christmas.
World-class strike.
Yeah, I said to Garth, I think he's the best left-sided player in the country, expecting an argument, and he said, I haven't disagreed with you. Today's goal, I think, was the best goal I've seen this season. I think it could be goal of the season. I think everyone who's played the game or plays the game on a Saturday and Sunday realises how hard the technique is to do what he did. Great balance, kept his eye on the ball, well-executed.
Well-deserved win?
I think so, under the circumstances. But it was a game like many of the games today that were characterised by poor refereeing decisions. I profoundly disagree with Jonathan Pearce, but let the people decide. The referee's entitled to interpret the laws of the game as he sees fit. He's the man in charge. But I do think they've got to use discretion, particularly when they're in danger of ruining the game.
OK, let's just take a moment, though, to enjoy another Welsh wizard, Craig Bellamy, making his debut, of course, today for Cardiff City. They ran out 4-0 winners. His was the fourth goal. And let's just enjoy this one against Doncaster Rovers, of course, in the Championship. That was not bad either, was it, Brighty?
I don't think it matters what league you score that goal in. It's a fantastic strike, dead ball. I think a perfect end for Cardiff for today. The expectation, I think, from missing out last year, the promotion, and starting this season in, what, four goals. Bothroyd played. I was really pleased for Dave Jones because he's been close on a few occasions.
Oh, they just ran out of steam, didn't they, last season?
Yeah, they did. He was in Bothroyd in the final.
What are you giggling at?
Says the girl from Cardiff.
I'm pleased for Craig Bellamy. It's always nice, isn't it, to do that on your debut.
It's a huge move. It's a huge move. I'm really pleased for him.
OK, West Ham, one of his former clubs. Terrible, terrible start to the season. Terrible end to the season. Just hanging in there in their Premier League survival.
They've got some serious problems, West Ham. They've got to do something very quickly to sort it out. The West Ham fans are booing. When they start booing, the manager has a problem.
I just think that they finished one place above the drop zone last year. They don't look like they're better organised in the defence, and there was some shambolic defending today at times. And I just wonder, Adam Grant, if he's been the right choice.
Everton still without their first win of the season. Slow starters, but he'll be disappointed, won't he?
There's a wonderful shot of, I think, Bill Kenwright looking forlorn at the players coming into the dressing room. He's not happy. David Moyes has got to get something going there because they've started very, very badly.
They started bad last year, but do you know what? Wolves, though, full credit to them. I think they're in the top three or four. They've started the season well. A win and a draw at Everton. It's a good result for them today.
OK, guys, thank you very much for your company. Stay with me. We're going, of course, onto the red button in a moment. Don't forget, as well, 6:06, you can get all the reaction to today's games with Mark Chapman and Robbie Savage, who made his 500th league appearance today. Lost. Never mind. It was still a good day. And that's on Radio 5, of course. From all of us, though, we'll see you on the red button in a moment. More interviews, more goals coming up. See you then.